Okay, so this was a dish I really ate very often when I was living in Singapore. I do like Indonesian Malaysian food, and the nasi padang was one of my favorite. The dish is really very flavorful and easy to make. So here I have taken eggplant, I have taken boiled baby potatoes, some fresh red chilies, onion and garlic. And my secret ingredient, which I will let you know later. So this is oil, which is on high flame. Add the brinjals in. You need to fry the entire thing on high flame, because on low flame, the eggplant or the brinjals is going to absorb some more oil. So let them fry through. This will take about 4 to 5 minutes, not more than that. Once they have fried well, you need to just remove them on a kitchen towel or a tissue paper and let the excess oil drain off. Now in the same oil, we are going to be adding the boiled baby potatoes, which I have just cut into half. You can use large potatoes also, but I need them basically into cube form or basically also cooked. Do not try to attempt to put the raw potatoes, because it is very time consuming to cook them through. So once they are fried well, just remove them alongside with the eggplant and let them both soak off all the excess oil. Now in the same oil again, I'm going to be frying the sambal ingredients, which is basically going to be the fresh red chilies, the garlic and the onion. So in goes here the garlic in hot oil, then the cubed roughly chopped onions and the two red chilies. These red chilies are spicy. Now this is the secret ingredient that I have put, is kaffir lime leaves. That really adds a amazing flavor. So I have just fried them a little bit. I don't want to turn them brown, nothing. I have just fried them and I have taken and kept them aside. Now once they cool down slightly, I have put them into a blender and I'm going to grind it to a very smooth paste. If you feel like adding a little bit of water, a splash, you can, but this is what it needs to reach to. Now I have removed the excess oil and I have just kept a little bit back into the same pot, and I've added the pureed masala, the sambal. I'm adding a little bit of salt and 2 teaspoons of sugar. Yes, the chilies were spicy, so I had to add the sugar. Normally there is either gula malaka, which is palm sugar, goes in, but I prefer to use the actual white sugar. Once you have fried the masala for a good 5 to 6 minutes, add in the brinjal and the baby potatoes, and now let this fry again, everything together. So if you're a vegetarian, this is perfect. If you're a non-vegetarian and okay with dried fish, then dried shrimps is something that actually goes into the sambal as well. That again takes the dish to a different level. So it's up to you how you would like to make it, the vegetarian or the non-vegetarian version. And sambal can be had with just plain rice, with a fried chicken, fried egg, or a chicken curry. It can be as a main or as a side. And it is absolutely cooked to perfection. The taste was amazing. I had it and I was planning to have it again, but obviously nothing remained. This was a small portion. This portion can serve two if you have other courses as well. If this is the main, then probably you will have to increase all the ingredients. The spice and the sweetness is up to you, how you would like to balance it out. And the tanginess part comes through the tomatoes, which is also optional. So give it a try. Happy cooking.